Jericho trying to get a cheap shot in. And that's Kurt Angle.
Kurt, what are you doing? Here's that weird thing again.
Oh, Angle's going to get his pedigree tap. But Jericho dims the lights of the game.
Well, the game wanted the Undisputed Championship. He got it right in his face.
And now Jericho and Angle. Jericho dismantling the game. And yeah. The game may be over, King.
Got that right because the living legend is taking over.
And here comes the Rock. Here comes the Rock. Amanda was really screwed by Jericho. And then the Rock hit it off on Angle.
Look out, Kurt.
Jericho got out of the ring with a scarlet dog. Not won any part of the People's Champion.
Let me make one thing perfectly clear to you. You and I might be partners tonight, but I do not need you to be my savior. Understand? What the blue hell are you so angry about? You walking around here so angry for? Walking around here mad? Your face all squinched up. What's all that about? You're so angry about it. Last night you won the Royal Rumble. You're going to WrestleMania. You should be happy. Go eat some ice cream. Go drink a protein shake. Go make yourself a ham and cheese sandwich. Go do something. But don't be angry. And just so you know, just so we're clear, The Rock wasn't coming down there to be your savior. That's the last thing in this world The Rock would ever do, is to be your savior. What The Rock did earlier tonight is exactly what you and The Rock are gonna do later tonight. And that's take Chris Jericho, take Kurt Angle, and whoop their candy asses all over Greenville. We're clear then. So let's play the game.
Turner King, congratulations in order for Trish. Great victory over Jazz for the women's title, but in the 15-year history of the World Wrestling Federation Royal Rumble, I have never seen anything more reprehensible than what The Undertaker did to young Maven, the first ever Tough Enough winner.
Now, wait a minute. Young Maven, as you like to call him, is still wet behind the ears as far as the World Wrestling Federation is concerned, and he should have known better than to attempt what he did to The Undertaker. You want to know what he did to The Undertaker? Take a look. This is reprehensible.
Oh, my. Well, I think business is about to pick up here because this yard belongs to one of the most evil, sinister, uncaring individuals in the history of the WWF.
You don't play in The Undertaker's yard. There's one thing I wouldn't want to be.
What's that, King?
Next.
It's Matt Hardy, accompanied by Lita. And The Undertaker put up Matt, Jeff, and Lita all on the shelf.
Matt Hardy could certainly use some help out here, couldn't he?
Yeah, he'd like to get it.
But maybe so, King.
What?
Here comes Jeff Hardy. And look at the reunion of the Hardys. They're back on the same page. And the Hardys with poetry and motion.
Hey!
But The Undertaker caught Jeff and eliminated him.
Oh, look out. That's it.
And the Hardys eliminated by The Undertaker, who takes back over his yard.
Now, once again, I wouldn't want to be next. Oh, no!
This is Maven, the first male Tough Enough winner in the Royal Rumble.
Aaron, you have a watch on. Does it have a second hand on
it? Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Put a clock on this one. Man.
And Lita still up on the apron.
Lita, what is your problem?
Didn't like what Undertaker did to Matt and Jeff.
Your young life.
And now The Undertaker, he's gonna try to extract some some revenge here on Maven. Undertaker has just turned absolutely psychotic after being eliminated from his own yard. This is sad what the Undertaker has done to this young man with his first opportunity in the Royal Rumble. Maven left battered and bloody. The Undertaker is so bitter, and a lot of people really think Maven got a real raw deal because the Undertaker was already eliminated when he incapacitated Maven.
Oh, Maven got a raw deal. You haven't heard all the talk the Undertaker's been dishing out about respect? I mean, this young punk Maven showed Undertaker no respect. He should have bowed down and jumped over the top rope and eliminated himself. Instead, he knocked the Undertaker out.
I know firsthand about the Undertaker's obsession for respect, sir.
And Y2J doing?
That could be a setup for the pedigree. Angling, never land. Here we go.
Oh, here
pedigree, pedigree. The pedigree.
Oh, look out.
Oh, Jericho's on the top rope. Had a title belt in his hand.
No.
Saying Soprano is the undisputed champion.
I don't know who that was worked for. Angle or Jericho?
King Luke. The game is ticking. The pedigree of Kurt Angle. Nobody going to get up for
that.
And Jericho off the top rope. Jericho came off the top rope.
You know why? Because that Jericho is a gamer. You got to admit it.
Jericho stopped what would have been no doubt a victory for Triple H and The Rock. Nobody gets up from the pedigree.
The Rock is just now getting up from that beat he took a few minutes ago. Come on, tag Y2J.
Jericho can't wait for the tag. The Rock, a little worse for wear, but he wants the tag on the other side. Who's going to get the tag?
Oh, The Rock's ready now. The Rock wants the lace of SmackDown.
A tag here could be the turning point. But both men made the tag. Oh, it's The Rock and the Undisputed Champion. The man that beat The Rock at the Royal Rumble.
Here it comes.
He's not getting a sweet, nothing sweet about that right hand.
So look at that. Reversal, look at that.
And Jericho, the bulldog down on the Rock.
That's it. If he hits that lion saw, now it's over. Where's he going? What's he doing? What do you want?
What are you looking for?
Here's the bell.
Jericho's got the damn ring bell.
The ring bell, look out.
Oh, my God, did you hear that? I think I have a skull is cracked.
Oh, my God.
People's champion. Match over. Game over. What a night. The Rock, Triple H, win it on Raw.
Down is an historic Charleston, and tonight it's Austin versus Booker T. Kurt Angle versus The Rock. The winners meet on Raw for a chance to meet Jericho for the undisputed title at No Way Out. Huge.
Well, Rock, last Sunday night, certainly a night of the unexpected. Unfortunately for you,
last Sunday night, Royal Rumble was a night of the unexpected. The unexpected in which nobody ever thought that. You're not paying attention to what The Rock is saying, Coach? What is your mind elsewhere, Coach? What are you thinking about, Coach? What are you thinking about what you're going to do after the show with all your friends? Is that what you're thinking about, Coach? What are you thinking about going dancing after the show? Is that what you're going to do? Huh?
All right.
Shut up. Well, The Rock says this. The Rock has an idea. Since you like dancing so much, and seeing as we are in the city we are in, why don't you, Coach, why don't you dance the Charleston?
Come on, Rock.
Shut your mouth. You don't make any decisions around here, Coach. Excuse The Rock 1 second, Coach. You don't make any decisions. Would you people like to see Coach dance the Charleston?
Yes!
Why not?
Oh, absolutely!
You see, Coach, they believe in you, The Rock believes in you, and we are on The Rock Show, we're on SmackDown, so Coach, why don't you dance the Charleston like you've never danced before?
What's this, Michael? You got no rhythm!
You remember how to do the Charleston. You took dancing, shut up. You took dance lessons as a kid. Now dance that Charleston, Coach. Dance.
Play that Barry Manilow music.
Yeah. Dance. Charleston. Turn the other way. Yeah, turn the other way. And face the camera. Yeah, smile at everybody at home.
You idiot.
Bend over. Get your monkey out of the Rock picture. Go on, pick him up, pick Coach up, you sick freak. Oh yeah, last Sunday was a night of unexpected at the Royal Rumble. Kane picking the Big Show up, throwing the Big Show over the top rope. Maven eliminating the Undertaker. And above all else, Ric Flair making Vince McMahon tap faster than Shirley Temple on an ice cream sandwich. But as far as The Rock's match with Chris Jericho goes, the way Chris Jericho won that match wasn't unexpected. We all expected Jericho to win the way he won, but what's over is over. It's done with, gone, past, history, old news. Because you see, Chris Jericho, you are still the undisputed champion, and Chris Jericho, you are still the biggest monkey's anus walking God's green earth. But you see, Chris Jericho and everybody else, that was Sunday. This is tonight. And tonight, The Rock faces Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle, the winner of tonight's match, has a shot to go on to No Way Out and face the Undisputed Champion. This time, last year, No Way Out, The Rock defeated Kurt Angle for the WWF Championship, went on to WrestleMania. And we all know what happened to The Rock at WrestleMania. We all know what happened to The Rock at the WrestleMania before that and the one before that. But The Rock says, this year, 2002, different. This WrestleMania, WrestleMania 18, different. You see, because just as sure as The Rock has air flowing through the lungs of The Rock, just as sure as The Rock has blood flowing and pouring through his veins, it's just as sure as The Rock has millions and millions of The Rock's fans, it's just as sure as this WrestleMania, Toronto, 60,000 strong, will be the biggest WrestleMania. The most electrifying WrestleMania, and The Rock guaranteed that this WrestleMania will be The Rock's WrestleMania. Kurt Angle, you get ready to roll. You get ready to roll. If you smell la, 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 what The Rock is cooking.
Oh, look out. Rock to the right hand.
For sure.
Another one by the bomber,
for sure. And the people just love that.
They love it when the
Rock. They just love when the Rock. Down. Yeah, sure. What about the Jeff?
Knock it out of there. And here comes the bomber ball. This place beginning to explode.
Come on, Angle.
DDT. Hook to the leg. It's over. No, Angle gets the shoulder up.
Ooh, that was close.
Get your head out of your rear end, Angle. Come on. Show some offense. You're an Olympic champion, damn it. Prove it. Prove it to me.
Angle's certain. He's in La La Land as the Brahma Bull, The Rock, building momentum. You can begin to feel it in this crowd here in Charleston. At the end, Kurt Angle stops The Rock.
There, Kurt's listening to you, Y2J. He's going to show you some offense.
Look at The Rock. He's out for the count. He's out on his feet. Just quit now, Rock.
The Rock has no quit, Chris Jericho. You should know that better than anybody.
Well, if he won't quit, he'll
what a beat. Jump up, Angle. On the top rope.
Oh, my God. Come on, Angle. Should be a disqualification, thrown over the top rope. Come on!
Should be.
Show me something, Angle!
I'll tell you, Jericho, if The Rock ever got his hands on you, you know what the Brahma Bull would do to you.
He had his chance on Sunday, now didn't he? I would beat The Rock's butt anytime.
Get him, Rock! Yeah! Take him out, Rock!
Hey! Look out!
And The Rock now with a right hand of Jericho.
sharpshooter.
Look at this! Jericho just pointed the referee out, and Angle's tapping! And Jericho pulled the refs out of the ring.
The ref didn't see, and he tapping. Here you go, Michael. Is that
real? And then what the hell is this? It's the Undertaker! Undertaker and Chokeslam! What the hell was that all about? The Undertaker just chokeslammed the Rock! The Undertaker assaulted the Rock! He drilled him! What the hell is the Undertaker doing out here?
The referee didn't see a damn thing. It was with Jericho!
This him that Goldust is talking about. That's what I can't figure out, but you gotta admit, Goldust made an impressive return at the Royal Rumble.
Boy, sure did, King. And speaking of the Royal Rumble, ladies and gentlemen, another young man that made his mark that we'll never forget is Maven, the kid that single-handedly eliminated the Undertaker from the Royal Rumble. We want to take you back to the sold-out Phillips Arena. The Undertaker had just cleared the ring of several superstars when Maven was introduced.
And bloodied by the Undertaker, a hell of a price to pay, but Maven was never officially eliminated from the Royal Rumble, and now tonight Maven has the opportunity again to shock the world against Y2J.
Boy, it just shows you don't have to play the lotto to be lucky. Just be Maven. Can he shock the world again tonight? We'll see.
Pull the roll up. Now Jericho.
Get him wild, the Jericho. There it is. Give up. Punk, your 15 minutes of favor over.
Maven. Time to reach for the ropes.
Tap out, you punk.
Maven trying to get to the bottom rope.
Put the pressure on him.
Jericho.
There you go. That's it.
And the tap out.
Thank God. Yeah, I knew it. That was never in doubt.
And still, the undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion, Chris Jericho.
I'll tell you what, King. You gotta give Maven a little pat on the back because he gave it everything he had.
Yeah, now he's nothing more than a trivia question. Kick him out of the ring. See ya. Wouldn't want to be ya.
Wait a minute. What the hell is this about?
I want to know.
Now, there may be the baddest dog in all the yard, the Undertaker.
Maven! Oh, your luck just went from bad to worse.
And Jericho got out of the ring like a scalded dog.
I'm glad I'm not Maven right now. Yeah, you want to join us? Here you go. You got a ringside seat.
And the Undertaker.
Did you see that beating, JR?
I saw it.
That's nothing compared to this beating that the Taker's gonna give this punk.
That was great what you did there.
Oh, it was easy.
I was never worried, were you?
He never had a chance.
I knew it.
Yeah, never had a chance. Look at this.
Uh-oh, he's putting on his work gloves.
He's gonna get a little revenge for Rumble. Look at that kid, what a punk.
How stupid is Maven? Hey, Beats, don't fail me now. Run, you idiot.
Undertaker just said I'm just gonna talk to him.
To talk to him.
He just told the referee that he's just going to talk to me.
He's going to give him a little wrestling lesson. Look at that. What a fair man.
There's nothing fair about the Undertaker, Jericho. Nothing fair.
There's nothing fair in the way that Maven threw the Undertaker out of the ring at the Rumble either, JR.
Right from behind.
Oh, look at that shot.
Oh,
that's going to cave in some ribs.
Yeah. Just talk and get out of there, referee. You don't want to talk to you.
This is sadistic. Absolutely.
Man.
Maven trying to fight back for the Undertaker. This kid's got more guts than brains.
You're right.
Look at the
That's
Undertaker.
For sure. He ain't got a lot of guts either, JR.
I think he's got plenty of guts.
Look at this.
And what does this mean to the Undertaker? I mean, this kid's already been in a championship match. And now this. What an exposed buckle.
Stomp his guts out. Here we go.
Oh. And Maven now top
right to the chest.
3-0. Whoa. Getting the hell stomped out of him.
This beating's almost as bad as the one I just gave him.
Oh, that was a bad one.
That was a bad one.
There's no reason for this. This is absolutely distasteful. How can the Undertaker even look himself in the mirror?
I'm enjoying this almost as much as I enjoyed beating the hell out of him during my match.
Oh, look at everybody run.
Get out of the way, Eaton.
Undertaker, that steel chair. He busted this kid open at the Royal Rumble to the Undertaker.
Look at this. Look at this. This is the most vicious move I've ever seen.
This is
going to
be nice.
What's Undertaker going to do here?
You know what's coming.
I have no idea what's... Oh, no, not...
No! Oh, my gosh!
That chair just right up into the throat of this young rookie.
That was vicious. What a vicious assault. He won't be screaming anymore after that one.
That was sick and sadistic.
That'll teach him to whine and complain. You got what you deserve, kid. That's poetic justice.
You gotta have some respect around here. You gotta respect the Undertaker. You gotta respect Y2K, well, the Undisputed Champion.
I'd love to know what's inside the Undertaker's head right now and what he must be thinking.
Well,
I mean, this is sick.
Look at that.
A premeditated assault on this kid because the Undertaker got eliminated fair and square at the Royal Rumble.
There was no fair and square. Maven attacked him from behind, and now Maven's paid the price.
That was
twice tonight.
That was vicious.
Well,
oh my God.
All right, well, still to come here, ladies and gentlemen. Stone Cold and Kurt Angle going to turn the number one contender for the Undisputed title, No Way Out Plus. Oh, what a collision. Triple H, Booker T, live tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a couple of moments ago, Maven with a gallant fight, a lot of guts in this kid, but he finally succumbed to the walls of Jericho, and Maven had no choice but to tap out, but the kid made a great showing of himself, King.
Oh,
he almost got the rope.
Oh, he could have made it so much easier on himself, JR. Just show some respect. But not only did he get an awful beating from Y2J, but then the Undertaker showed up.
No!
Well, Undertaker driving that, to say it one more time, Undertaker driving that chair right into the throat of Maven, who's getting some attention now from the EMTs. And King, we're told that Maven is having a heck of a lot of problems breathing and that shot in the throat.
Saying that it's possible a crushed esophagus. And you know, I'm sorry about that. But
he didn't deserve that.
I realize that, but he brought it on himself, JR.
Now, wait a minute.
Excuse me, Undertaker. Two unprovoked attacks. First, The Rock on SmackDown, and now Maven here tonight.
Coach, let me ask you a question. Are those your teeth?
Yes, sir, they are.
Would you like to keep your teeth in your mouth?
Yes, sir, I would.
Well, can I suggest to you that you never say the name Maven out loud in my presence again? Because if you do, I will be wearing your teeth as a necklace. You know, that little punk, he comes down, I could have put him out right away. But no, out of the kindness of my heart, I spared him. I said, I'm gonna let this kid get a little ring time. So as I'm slapping knots on the Hardy Boy's head, what's he do? He takes a liberty, kicks me in the back, and out I go. Well, that was his decision. Now he's gotta live with the consequences. He paid at the Rumble, he paid it tonight, and he will continue to pay, Coach, until I decide that he's paid up. As far as The Rock goes, what business is it of The Rock's who eliminated me? Was Rock in the Rumble? No, he wasn't in the Rumble. So it's none of his business. But he sees fit to tell the whole world who eliminated The Undertaker. Yeah, it was Maven, but it still ain't any of his business. You see, everything's a big joke to The Rock. Everything's a big song and dance. Well, you see, Coach, I'm not you. I don't sing and I don't dance. And I don't get disrespected. What happened to The Rock last week will continue to happen every time he disrespects me. And come to think of it, I don't think he thought what happened at SmackDown was too funny. so maybe he'll decide to keep his mouth shut. Are we done, Coach?
Yes, sir, we're done.
Why are you still here?
That's an evil man. A heart.
The Rock. Hold on. Before I leave, I just wanted to tell you that you're everything I heard you were and more.
Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you. Good luck to you. And, thanks for the memories. Nature Boy.
The Rock could be pedigree. Time it is! And look at the Undertaker with a steel chair and a shot to the back of the head. That damn vicious Undertaker is going to be disqualified.
I don't think he cares at this point. Look out, ref.
And a shot to the head of Triple H.
Wow. Hear that?
What is wrong with the Undertaker? Another vicious assault here tonight. Oh, look at The Rock from behind. The Rock with right hands to the Undertaker. A Bravo Bull unloading! Undertaker knocked over the top rope! The Rock laying the SmackDown! A huge score to settle for The Rock!
Retribution for last Thursday night!
Oh, look at The Rock. Oh, what the hell's The Rock doing here?
Wait a minute! Hold it, Rock! Now calm down! Look out! Rock, what are you doing?
The Rock ripping apart our announce table.
Easy,
chair.
Rock. Take it easy now! No, wait! We need that stuff!
And The Undertaker with a boot to the face. Rock took way too much time. And The Undertaker floored him with a boot to the head.
I tried to warn The Rock. He just wouldn't listen to us.
And The Undertaker driving The Rock right into the ring bell. And The Rock looks down and out on his feet. This vicious, this sadistic, this monster, this Undertaker is an absolute animal.
Oh, not another steel chair.
And The Undertaker, who's made a living with steel chairs in recent weeks.
What the hell's he gonna do now?
I don't know, but he's mighty close to... Oh, watch this!
Oh, no, not this! Not this! Oh, look out! The Undertaker was gonna try to crush The Rock's throat! And a shot to the midsection of The Rock by The Undertaker.
Oh, look out!
The Undertaker was hell-bent on crushing the throat of The Rock! Undertaker and Rock continue. This is utter chaos and destruction here at ringside. Look out! The Rock! Rock bottom! Rock bottom! The Rock! Rock bottom! The Undertaker! Straight through the announce table. Look at this! To Angle! With the ankle lock locked in! Angle's gonna try to break Triple H's ankle! His damn match is over! Angle wants to break the ankle of Triple H!
Tap out! Triple H, don't break your ankle!
And look at the way that ankle's contorting! Look at Angle's face. Officials into the ring, and Kurt Angle snapped.
Oh, he snapped all right. He went Olympic on Triple H. Triple H ankle may be broken.
What? It is a train wreck at ringside, Kane. And look at this again. Again. Angle with an ankle lock on that steel ramp. Angle wants to break the ankle of Triple H.
Look at Kurt Angle's face. He's a madman.
He's a rabid dog. What the hell's gotten into him?
Watch it.
What has gotten into Kurt Angle, Ken?
You can't blame him. He's been provoked here tonight.
Provoked? Are you nuts?
No, I'm not nuts. He's been provoked.
How the hell is he provoked?
You see what happens when you provoke Kurt Angle. Look at this carnage. Look at the Undertaker.
Driving the Undertaker through the announce table with a rock bottom. Kurt Angle trying to break the ankle of Triple H. Kurt Angle may have broken the ankle of Triple H. What the hell else is going to happen here tonight? What a night!
Excuse me, sir. Undertaker, excuse me, kind of a touchy subject, but just wanted to get your reaction to getting rock bottom through a table by The Rock on SmackDown Thursday night.
My reaction? Who in the hell are you to ask me about what my reaction is? What business is yours? My reaction. What's wrong, Cole? I sense fear. Do you fear me?
because I like that. You know, fear and respect, they go hand in hand. My reaction? I feel like I've been disrespected. I feel like The Rock disrespected me. So tonight, I'm gonna take The Rock and I'm gonna teach him the word respect. And when I'm done with him, I'm gonna move to Stone Cold Steve Austin. And then I'm gonna teach him respect.
First of all, Taker, nobody respects you more than I do. Nobody respects everything you've accomplished in the WWF more than me. But just to let you know, tonight's match is not a handicap match. Tonight's match is a tag team match.
Your point is?
Oh, my point is this. Tonight, your partner is a larger-than-life, living legend, undisputed champion of the world. And if you have any problem at all teaching those two about respect, I just want to let you know that tonight, I've got your back. Tonight, the champ has got your back.
Well, Rock, we heard the big announcement from Vince McMahon earlier tonight regarding the NWO. Now, I understand that you have a big announcement of your own.
Yeah. The Rock has a big announcement. But you see, The Rock's announcement does not concern Scott Hall, Kevin Nash, or Hulk Hogan. The Rock's big announcement concerns The Undertaker. You see, Undertaker.
Fans here wanting to let The Rock talk.
They love The Rock.
You see, Undertaker. 2 weeks ago on SmackDown, you came in The Rock's match. You chokeslammed The Rock, costing The Rock the Undisputed Championship. So now Undertaker, The Rock's big announcement. It's 2 weeks from now at No Way Out. Dead Man Walking is gonna walk right into going one-on-one with the Great One.
Wow. Uh-oh. The talents of The Undertaker.
But Undertaker, let's think about this. Why did you get involved in The Rock's match? Why? Because The Rock had the nerve to mention that Maven threw you out of the ring at the Royal Rumble? Is that why, Undertaker? Why? Because in the very same interview, The Rock dared to make Coach right here dance the Charleston like he's never danced before. Is that why, Undertaker? Undertaker, will you get something straight right here, right now? You see, The Rock does not answer to you. You see, Undertaker, The Rock is not the Undertaker's champion. No. The Rock is the people's champion. But you see, Undertaker leaves The Rock with two choices. What The Rock could do right now is he could go out and he could prepare for his match, his tag match tonight, after The Rock sings a verse of his favorite song called Viva Rock Vegas.
Oh, Viva Rock Vegas!
Or, Undertaker, if it were up to you, what The Rock could do is simply not do that, not entertain, not electrify. What The Rock does best, entertain, electrify the millions. And millions of The Rock's fans. So if it's up to you, Undertaker, The Rock could just walk away right now. I guess the choice is obvious.
Hey!
What is this?
What the Undertaker wants him to do?
Rock just walked away.
Well, The Rock's big announcement, 2 weeks. The Rock, The Undertaker, one-on-one at No Way Out. But
uh-oh.
Viva Rock Vegas one more time, and I think he's gonna get the opportunity. Here he
champion. Where the SmackDown on the Undisputed Champion. Jericho counters, and the Rock downstairs.
No!
Big time DDT.
Look out!
And now the Undertaker. He tried to come from behind, but the Rock cuts the Undertaker off.
Look out!
Oh! The king-size bed right for the Undertaker.
Oh, my!
Spine on the pine!
Wait a minute!
Sharp's here! The Rock and the Sharp's here! On Rock TJ!
Locked in, but here comes the Undertaker!
Take another cheap shot from behind, nailing the Rock.
Oh, no, not again!
And Austin takes the Undertaker outside. And Jericho knocks Austin down and gets Austin outside.
Watch it!
And here comes the Brahma Bull with one big horn for the Undisputed Champion.
They're all outside.
And this son of a gun is, it has lost all semblance of a tag team man. And Jericho getting beat by a government mule here by both The Rock and Austin.
Hey, hey.
And look at the Undertaker grabbing Austin.
Austin got stuck there.
Jericho.
Look at this.
Oh, Jericho. Look at the walls. Jericho got the walls of Jericho on The Rock. Austin.
Oh, man.
Austin back in. Sure as hell was not. Austin got the stunner. The Rock rolls over. Got the cover. And the Undertaker pulled the damn referee out of the ring.
That was fair. That's only fair.
And now Austin and the Undertaker hammering each other again. And the Rock ready to unplug in the ring on Y2J.
You got Jericho and the Rock right behind you.
Brawl on the outside. In the skull. The Undertaker may have concussed the Rock with that lead pipe. The Rock is lying motionless thanks to the Undertaker and that sickening assault. Jericho got the cover. Jericho got the lead. Jericho got the three.
You're right.
Here
I saw it.
Chris Jericho and the Undertaker.
Steel pipe. Jericho and the Undertaker win it. But let me tell you, in 13 days, my God, there'll be no way out for the Undertaker or Jericho.
Undertaker, you want to hit the Rock in the head with a steel pipe? You want to beat some respect into the Rock? Well, let the Rock show you what kind of respect he has for you. Undertaker, the Rock knows you're here tonight. He knows you didn't have a match against Maven tonight, but the Rock says that has to wait. Because right now, Undertaker, the Rock wants you to come
right
out.
Can you dig it, sucker?
Wait a minute. The Rock was calling out the Undertaker, but this is fucker T King. What business does he have with The Rock?
I know that fucking T sucker, but
can
I don't know why he's out here.
Sucker!
I mean, they got something on his mind. Look at that look on his face.
This is a carbon copy of what happened on Raw Monday night when Booker T interrupted Triple H.
You know something, Rock? There's one thing I can't stand, and that's a sucker with a big ego and a big head like yours.
Uh-oh, who's talking?
You see, I'm the one who beat Triple H last week. I'm the one who kicked his ass last Monday night.
sucker.
And I'm the one that's gonna make an example out of you. Now can you dig that, sucker?
Uh-oh. I don't know of anybody that's ever made an example out of The Rock.
Oh, The Rock can dig it. The Rock can dig it, cause see, you see Booker T goes down like this. You see, you wanna come out and make an example out of The Rock? The Rock saw you last week. You wanna be in the movie so bad? Well, The Rock, I'll tell you this, Booker T, why don't you come on down and you and The Rock, we can make a movie right here live on SmackDown.
And here comes Booker T.
Oh, The Rock's not done. The Rock's not done. No, Booker T. The Rock's not done. You want to be a leading man? We got the lights. We got the cameras. We got the action. You come on in. The name of the movie is going to be The Rock whooping your candy all over L.A.
And here comes Booker T. And what a way to kick off SmackDown. The Rock and Booker T. There ain't even a referee out here, T.
Roll the cameras. Action. Here we go.
Impromptu matchup. Rock off the ropes. Ducks underneath the ropes. Up to kick off SmackDown and a kick to the face by Booker T. The Rock laying the SmackDown to Booker T. This impromptu matchup. Start this off on SmackDown. This is with a right hand and a shot by The Rock. Booker T off the ropes. Oh, what a throw by The Rock. Quickly The Rock into the cover. Hook to the leg. There's one. There's two. And Booker T just kicks out. Also here tonight, a big pose down. Billy and Chuck against Stacy and Tori, a pose down on SmackDown.
That's what I'm happy about. I think I'm going to get to MC that. A puppy pose down tonight. Woo-hoo.
What a shock. You're going to MC the pose down.
Well, I'm the king of skin, you know.
Booker T, the scissors kick to the back of the head. And what a huge win this would be for Booker T.
You know what I call that? That's a sucker kick.
You think we're going to see the Hollywood version?
I think we're going to get your cameras rolling. This is a sucker beat the mill moment here. Grinding that elbow, that forearm into the face of Maven.
He's making him taste and smell his own blood, King.
The school that Maven's attending right now has a psychotic principal, doesn't it? There he is, the Undertaker. Where's Al Snow? Is he unconscious somewhere? He's always unconscious. Hey, Al.
And here it is. This is the taking care of business, King. The Undertaker locking in the submission maneuver. He's going to try to choke out, try to hurt this kid, King.
Wait a minute. It's The Rock. What? The Rock with a steel chair.
What?
The Undertaker. The Rock stuck in the Undertaker.
What the? What's he doing here?
A shot at the Undisputed Championship. And because of that, we ain't even. We ain't never gonna be even. Why? Because The Rock hit him in the head with a chair and rock bottomed his candy ass? Is that why? We ain't even. We ain't even this week. We ain't even next week. And at No Way Out, we damn sure ain't gonna be even. Because of fact.
Hey! The Undertaker! The Undertaker!
We ain't even.
Ambushing The Rock from behind, King!
Well, come once again!
No, we ain't even, Rock. No.
The Rock's
no,
back.
You wanted this thing. Get your ass up here.
What the hell's he doing?
No. You want to be all that, huh?
Come and they're here. On top of that limousine.
Oh, my God.
Give me a deuce.
No. You got to be kidding me. Oh, my God. No.
No, no.
A tombstone. A tombstone into the roof of the limousine. What a sick, sick human being!
Somebody get some help for Rock!
I feel so good, I feel so numb, yeah!
Well, there you hear, Michael, that's Rob Zombie's Feel So Numb. And by the way, Rob Zombie sits right over here behind us. And by the way, that song is the No Way Out pay-per-view theme song. Rob Zombie!
It is awesome, Feel So Numb. But folks, moments ago, The Rock being interviewed after costing The Undertaker the Hardcore title earlier tonight. And check out The Undertaker, a vicious ambush from behind. But King,
what would follow was simply sadistic. Oh, without a doubt. You can hear The Rock's head rammed into the hood of that limousine. And then a choke slam on the hood.
Well, King, this was more than just about causing injury. It was about trying to end a man's career. A tombstone onto the roof of that limo, a sickening thud. Well, this is live, folks, in the parking garage of the Staples Center. Paramedics attending to The Rock. You see the EMTs securing the neck with a brace, taking all the necessary precautions, moving The Rock onto that backboard. The Rock's going to be transported to a medical facility. Tell you, The Undertaker talks about respect. That man respects no one. And these actions and this injury to The Rock, Well, that shows that. That underlines that.
You see, I didn't know what to expect, but I could tell you people really do appreciate the man who finally shut The Rock's mouth.
Oh. I don't think so. Well, they did. I think that ovation just changed.
Now, you see, that's more of the backwoods, unappreciative, disrespectful. Response that I would get from a bunch of hillbillies like you. You see, I didn't expect much from you because I learned a long time ago, don't look for much from people who have no reason to respect themselves. Now, last Thursday on SmackDown,
you're starting this rock chant. Believe me, you don't want to get this man angry, folks.
Don't make me come out there.
See? He needs to come.
Thursday on SmackDown, a man showed me no respect who has nothing but respect for himself. That's right, The Rock. You know what? I'm not gonna waste any more of my time with you podunks.
This is what happened last Thursday. The Rock.
Because quite frankly, the smell is starting to get to me. Look. You see that? The Rock.
The Rock cost The Undertaker the match with Maven.
The hardcore title?
You know he did, JR.
That was a shot of an unwarranted, unprovoked attack perpetrated on The Undertaker by The Rock. Now, I tell you what, it's one thing not showing me my proper respect, but nobody, and I mean nobody, disrespects me like that. Because if you do disrespect me, if I can bring it up one more time, I will show you what will happen.
Next week, and at No Way Out, we damn sure ain't gonna be even.
And The Rock was being interviewed. If you saw the assault from behind, we should add by The Undertaker. And man, this, it was bad enough with those big soup bones. The choke slam with the hook in the limo. But The Undertaker walks it through, King.
You got that right. Watch this. And listen. Listen to The Rock's hit. Being Tombstone. Listen.
Oh, The Rock's skull on the top of that limo. Oh, sure as hell aren't even.
I'm proud of that.
Now that is what I call an ass kicking. But see, it doesn't end right there. No, 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 no. We're just now getting started.
Uh-oh. It's gonna get worse?
The beatings will continue until I teach Rock the word respect. And believe me, I am no Aretha Franklin, and I won't be singing it. I will continue to beat the word respect into The Rock's head until he sings R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Taker, that's what you mean to me.
And clearly these fans over the years, whether they've liked you or not liked you, have respected you for being the Undertaker, the dead man. But last Thursday night, to continue, you lost all our respect. You caused The Rock to have a grade one concussion, a serious neck injury. Hell, you could have ended his career.
Who are you to tell me that you don't respect me?
Uh-oh.
Who in the hell are you?
I knew this was gonna happen. Blow up right here.
I'm Ric Flair, 50% owner of this company, and I'm telling you that.
I think the Undertaker cares about that.
Well, let me tell you something, Mr. 50%. When the real owner, he gives me the word, I'm gonna bust your ass.
Well, until that happens, I got some bad news for you.
What's he talking about?
First part being that this Sunday at No Way Out, The Rock will be there live and in person. And he told me he's gonna bring everything he has for the dead man.
He's gonna need it.
Yeah. I got some more bad news for you. Tonight, one-on-one,
he's getting ready to run.
The dead man, the phenom, the Undertaker, the American badass is gonna wrestle here tonight.
He's just having his way with this rattlesnake.
Undertaker now going to that cover. Looking for three here. And Austin barely able to kick out.
Oh, look at this.
And that's four on the Undertaker. That is a brutal assault right there. Rubbing that forearm right across the bridge of the nose, across the cheekbones of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I can't even begin to tell you how bad that hurts, too. I mean, that's just, especially with the force, the power.
Sold out crowd here at Arkansas State, getting behind the rattlesnake. That may be too little too late.
And it's certainly not the smartest thing to do either, because it's just going to further irritate the dead man.
You know, Undertaker's a fat son of a gun, but when you're assaulted by the Undisputed Champion, as Austin was by Jericho, before this match even started, it puts you at a distinct disadvantage. In the end, certainly looks to be near for Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, no!
Looks like The Rock.
All that's missing is the limousine.
A Tombstone Piledriver, and also able to come off those shoulders. Austin, found a stunner. A stunner. And both men are down.
Where did that come from?
Austin from nowhere hit the stunner.
Hey, speaking of from nowhere.
Wait a minute, what the hell? It's that damn Jericho.
He's back. Oh, man.
The referee again, he's calling for the bell, and Jericho assaulting Austin for the second time.
Putting the boots to the rattlesnake. Look out.
Jericho's got one of those championship belts.
Uh-oh.
And Spinebuster. The spine on the prime. Oh, the Undertaker almost takes Austin's head off with that huge kick. And look at Jericho like a piranha.
Come on.
Picking the bones.
Talk Impact. Steph and I are really looking forward to No Way Out this Sunday. But you guys, Hulkster. You and Hall and Nash, I mean, you want to talk about impact. I can almost feel the poison flowing through the WWF veins as we speak. Oh, yeah. You're going to enjoy it. Oh, and speaking of enjoying it, I think you're going to enjoy the little surprise, the Valentine's Day surprise that Steph has for Triple H later tonight. Yeah. I'll look forward to it, too. Hey, listen, how about I give you a call back, huh? Yeah. I'll talk to you later.
What's happening, boss? How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Steph, how you holding up?
Hanging in there.
You know, that was wrong what he did.
That's
just great.
You know, on tonight in this tag match.
Nah, don't worry about the tag match, boss. We'll get to that.
Haven't you enjoyed today?
Well, so far I have.
Enjoyed the quiet?
The quiet. Have you ever noticed that wherever you walk, generally there's quiet?
Yeah. But this is something a little extra. No Rock.
As a matter of fact, I have enjoyed that bit of quiet.
You like
it quiet.
Yeah,
I do like
that.
It quiet. And I tell you what, mm-hmm. if he shows up in No Way Out, it's going to be quiet around here for a long time.
That sounds good.
Now, as far as that tag match goes,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to bust that little Maven up. I think I owe him one.
Yeah.
As far as Triple H goes, man, he's in for it, I'm telling you.
Hey, everybody. Kurt, listen, Steph, I apologize for knocking you down last week on SmackDown. That was intended for your husband, the jerk, Triple H.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? You deserve a lot better.
You're right, I do.
Oh, it's true. And speaking of the jerk, tonight me and The Undertaker, we're going to take care of him.
Yeah.
We're going to break every bone in his body.
Yeah.
We're going to make him suffer.
Yeah.
Just like in No Way Out, I'm going to make him suffer.
Yes.
I'm going to shatter his dreams of becoming Undisputed Champion.
Oh, yes. You know what, Kurt? I don't even care if Triple H makes it to No Way Out.
He might not.
I want the two of you to rip Triple H apart from limb to limb.
You got it.
So violent. But I tell you what. You tell me what body part you want, and I'll make sure Kurt and I bring it to you on a silver platter.
Oh, it's true.
Well, then seeing as how it's Valentine's Day,
yeah.
I want you to bring me his heart.
His heart is.
We can do that. No problem.
Triple H battling back with the elbows. And this is broken down into a two-on-one. Oh, his head! And I'm the Undertaker. Oh, Triple H one-on-one.
Wait a minute. What happened here? Come on, Kurt. Get back in there.
The Undertaker and Triple H exchanging blows. Triple H off the ropes. Undertaker telegraphed it. A face buster to the Undertaker.
Oh, no.
And Triple H. Oh, could he do it? Could he do it with the pedigree? An angle with a chair. A chair from behind.
That'll take the heart out of it.
A vile shot. And now the punishment continues. The referee's called for the bell. An angle driving the steel into the temple, into the ribs of Triple H. Failed by a number of shots. Oh no. The Undertaker telling Kurt Angle to get him up to him. We've seen The Undertaker do some vile things with these chairs in the past.
You're right now, Michael. They're doing Stephanie McMahon's bidding.
They're doing Mr. McMahon's bidding as well.
Hey,
The Undertaker. Hey, wait a minute. Ric Flair grabs the chair from The Undertaker. Ric Flair and The Undertaker face to face.
What's he doing out here?
The core of this company coming to the aid of Triple H, stopping this carnage.
All right. What? He stopped it. That's good. Be careful, Undertaker. He's an under. Or he's an under. That's kind of be careful, Undertaker.
Ric Flair. Wait a minute. No! The Undertaker just assaulted Ric Flair.
Oh, my gosh.
A boot to the face of a co-owner of this company.
Well, Flair, you can only bring yourself for that.
What will be the repercussions of this?
I don't know. Look at Kurt.
The Undertaker. And Kurt Angle can't even believe it. Oh, no.
Wait,
damn it. Stop this.
Whoa. Tiger, no. No. No, wait a moment. Wait just a moment. No. Wait. Not on Flair. Not at the moment. No. Now you see, I want Ric Flair. I want Ric Flair to be able to make it to No Way Out this Sunday. Because I want Ric Flair. No. Well, not now. I want him to make it to No Way Out this Sunday because it's on Flair's conscience.
It's Ric Flair's fault that the NWO is going to inflict the poison in the veins of the WWF this Sunday. I want Flair to see it. I want him to feel it. Save him. Save him for this Sunday.
Well, look out.
But as far... No. As far as Triple H is concerned, I've granted my daughter a very special provision this Sunday at No Way Out. Yeah, a very special provision. Tell him, Steph.
You see, Hunter, this Sunday when you face Kurt Angle and your WrestleMania title shot is on the line, baby, I'm gonna be the guest referee.
What?
Happy Valentine's Day. Get it,
Mark,
get it!
Oh my God!
Did you hear that, Michael?
I heard it, and I also heard the sickening thud from that damn angle to the skull of Triple H.